All right, thank you. Thank you for joining, and welcome to this week's new product update. My name is Jake Boydston, and I'm a product marketing engineer here at Texas Instruments. Today, I will be covering a short list of products used for isolated power and high voltage applications. Today's agenda will include a brief overview of high voltage product types, an example of different architectures using these product types, and details of our new solutions to meet your various needs. Before I begin with the presentation, I'll start by ensuring you that when it comes to power, we have quite a bit of experience. We have products originally designed by TI, Unitrode, and National Semiconductor, and we've shipped over 2 billion units over the past 35 years. Okay, so let's start with the first type of isolated DC-DC product that we all are very familiar with, the controller. It has external FETs, external transformer, typically used for loads greater than 10 watts, and can handle most any voltage input. Next, we have the converter, which integrates the FETs, most often are used for conversions less than 10 watts, and typically can only handle inputs less than 65 volts. And last but not least, the module. Modules integrate the transformer and are intended for low power and low voltage inputs as it stands today. Each of these product types has its own value proposition, and at the simplest level can be summarized by their flexibility to design, trading off with its integration and power density. To make sense of how these product types trade off, I'll start with an application example of an automotive traction inverter with a high voltage electric battery, typically 400 or 800 volts. Specifically, let's focus on the bias supply portion of the inverter, and let's assume the total load here required is less than 10 watts. The power stage requires galvanically isolated gate drivers in a three-phase fashion in order to turn the electric motor and provide enough power to the car. So how should we provide the power to the gate drivers on the high voltage side? The first architecture we could use would be what we call a centralized architecture, typically utilizing one transformer with multiple windings to bias the gate drivers in the inverter stage. Centralized architectures are fairly low BOM count and can be relatively low cost. It may not be optimal if your system is prone to electromagnetic interference or EMI, has high switching frequency, or high DVDT. The second architecture option is a semi-distributed approach, typically using one transformer to bias your three common ground low side drivers, and maybe one transformer to bias the three high side drivers separately with multiple windings. The semi-distributed architecture can enable higher performance for EMI and CMTI, or common mode transient immunity, for example, but may involve a higher BOM count. The biggest point to note here is that you can reduce your risk of total inverter failure by up to 50%. The last approach here would be a distributed architecture, which pairs bias supplies one-to-one with each gate driver. This approach will have the highest density and highest performance. Note that you can actually maintain a fairly low BOM count and get the highest reliability in the system at the same time. Each power stage you design will have its own key requirements, so the key to being successful is understanding these trade-offs and the options available to solve the system challenges. Now, you may have noticed it from the images, but this is how we see the controllers, converters, and modules working best due to their inherent capabilities as it stands with today's technologies. With that, high performance does not require high cost, so stay tuned as we showcase our newest products on the market. Okay, now on to the product showcases. To keep our order the same, I'll start with the controller hero products you may be interested in. Here are a few examples of topologies used for systems requiring less than 200 watts. If you work on projects utilizing multiple of these topologies, hopefully you are aware that one PWM controller could be configured for any of these four topologies and even more. Our top selling products are these three families here, and you'll notice the Unitrode naming convention on the UC2842, for example. Each one has its own value proposition, and again, it depends on your system requirements. In addition to being multi-topology, you may also consider these PWMs if you need a tunable fixed frequency due to your final solution having a high noise environment at your customer's end site. If you're unfamiliar with these products, I definitely recommend checking out the TI.com reference design page, where you can find examples of how to use the PWM controllers for any topology you are targeting. If you're looking specifically for a variable frequency flyback controller, I've showcased a few key flyback product types that you should consider. If you are looking for the lowest system cost, consider our UCC28600 quasi-resonant flyback. If you're looking for the highest efficiency and density, maybe the UCC28782 active clamp flyback would be most optimized for your needs. But if you're looking for a blend of low cost and high efficiency, our UCC28781 zero voltage switching flyback is a sweet spot between the two. Plus, you get the benefit of a very low standby power of 35 milliwatts in the system. Okay, so now that I've covered a few controller options for you, I will get to our newest products, which are focused in the converter and module groups. Specifically here, I will focus on the UCC25800-Q1. The UCC25800-Q1 is a low-cost transformer driver with high performance. It can take in a wide voltage input range of 9 volts up to 34 volts, and within that range, the power output scales with input voltage. This type of product is fairly new on the market, as most transformer drivers have typically operated from a low voltage of 5 volts. This one runs with a fixed frequency at 50% duty cycle and an open loop control method for simplicity and consistent performance, even with load variations. Its automatic dead time enables zero voltage switching for 85% or higher efficiency. As we think back to our three-phase traction inverter example, the UCC25800-Q1 could be used very nicely to drive three single output transformers for your three high side gate drivers from one converter. Now you may ask how it works or why should I choose this product? Well, one of the key benefits of the UCC25800-Q1 is its extremely low EMI. It operates as an LLC converter utilizing a high leakage inductance, which minimizes interwinding capacitance in the transformer to achieve a tightly regulated sinusoidal output. With that, it has a very high CMTI, performing very well in high DVDT applications, such as driving GAN switches. On the left of the page, you can see performance data compared to that of a similar flyback, and on the right, an example layout paired with an isolated gate driver. Another key benefit of this product is its transformer. Most transformers used today in designs similar to this one require difficult manufacturing processes to ensure the lowest leakage inductance possible. Because the UCC25800-Q1 utilizes the resonant LLC topology, it opens a newer type of transformer to be used, the split bobbin transformer, with a very high leakage inductance. As a result of this high leakage inductance, and as mentioned, you can attain a very low primary to secondary side capacitance of less than 2 picofarads and a very high CMTI of greater than 150 volts per nanosecond. This type of transformer is much easier for your magnetics vendors to manufacture all in one step, which enables lower cost to them, ultimately to you. It also enables them higher yields and tighter tolerances as well. Less variation in these transformers. Be sure to check out the application note on the product page for the UCC 25800-Q1 for transformer design considerations, as well as a list of off-the-shelf part numbers you can select for your next design. If you are interested in potentially using the UCC 25800-Q1 in your next design, I would recommend requesting one of our evaluation modules, which can be used with or without the pre-regulator, depending on your needs. Also, be sure to read the data sheet as well as the application note just mentioned to learn more from our in-house product experts on the LLC topology and much more. Okay, last but not least, I will cover TI's latest innovative product, the UCC 14240-Q1 module. The UCC 14240-Q1 has raised the bar for modules and given power density a new meaning. We all recognize the transformer seen on the left, or you may even have to purchase your own custom transformer for your designs. When it comes to biasing isolated gate drivers, the UCC 14240-Q1 takes all of the complexity out of the equation and is extremely simple to use and configure. By integrating the control, the FET, the transformer, and 1% regulation into a DWN package, it can reduce your solution volume by 50% and make your manufacturing processes extremely more simple to put together. Some key specs to highlight about the product. It provides a minimum of 1.5 watt of power at temperatures commonly seen in traction inverters, grid infrastructure, PLC systems, and more. It takes in a 24-volt input nominally and provides dual adjustable outputs to bias most power switches used in traction inverters, for example, such as silicon carbide, IGBTs, and more. The UCC 14240-Q1 outputs with 1.3% or greater, often even up, down to 1% regulation, which can enable you to optimize your switch efficiency and purchase smaller modules for your system. It also has many reliability features, including a power good startup routine, over temperature protection, under voltage lockout, over voltage lockout, and more. I'll note, to configure the output voltages, you'll see here in the schematic that using resistors R1 and R2, R3 and R4 are enable you to offset the outputs for any gate drive that you are looking to do in your design. Here's a glimpse of some preliminary data, including the soft startup, burst mode control for light load efficiency, and 2 watts of power output just above room temperature. The power good feature I'd like to specifically highlight as it monitors the startup routine of your load and ensures that the gate driver is operational before fully starting to eliminate overshoot in the system. If you're interested in experimenting with the UCC 14240-Q1, I would again recommend requesting one of our EVMs as shown here in high detail. You'll note that the only passives required to operate the IC are resistors and capacitors. A very simple and very easy design in a highly dense layout. So with that, I'll go ahead and summarize. I know I was fairly quick here, but I think I have told the story and made the point of how these products and product types might fit into your next design. And so let's come back to our three-phase traction inverter to tie it all up. As discussed earlier, each architecture has its trade-offs and may be optimal depending on your next design's requirements. If you choose a centralized format, consider our PWM and flyback controllers to accomplish your system's goals. If you're looking to reduce potential system failure with a semi-distributed approach, the ECC25800-Q1 transformer driver may be your best solution and enable you to optimize your EMI performance as well. If power density or gate drive performance are of most critical to you, the ECC14240-Q1 will by far exceed your needs in the system. And with that, that will conclude today's new product update from our side, and we will hang around for questions that you may have.
Great. Thank you, Jake, and thank you everybody for attending today. We do have a few more minutes, so we, like Jake said, will stay online so you can ask your questions in the chat. But we hope we see you same time next week for the topic VCube Link industrial high-speed video applications. Thank you and have a great week.